Well, we'll have some really blunt talk from the defense secretary and really a message to those pushing for a no-fly zone. Robert Gates saying if you want it, it's going to mean the U.S. military attacking Libya.
The opposition seized this oil-rich area, and on Wednesday, Libyan jets bombed it, dropping three bombs near anti-Gaddafi fighters. It's why some U.S. senators are clamoring for a no-fly zone.
I believe that the global community cannot be on the sidelines while airplanes are allowed to bomb and strafe.
But Pentagon officials say if you want to stop Libya's jets from bombing, the U.S. has to bomb Libya.
Let's just call a spade a spade. A no-fly zone begins with an attack on Libya to destroy the air defenses.
Libya is believed to have hundreds of anti-aircraft guns and portable surface-to-air missiles. They're old, probably not in great shape, but they work.
You can take those out up front. You can wait, which is not a very good option.
Retired General David Deptula commanded the no-fly mission over Iraq. He says the U.S. and its allies have to decide why they'd impose a no-fly zone over Libya, on humanitarian grounds or to help the opposition overthrow Gaddafi.
So what are the rules of engagement involved with applying that force?
When it comes to taking out air defenses.
Well, right. Do you wait for Gaddafi's aircraft to take off, or do they have to commit a hostile act? How do you define the hostile act? Is it against a member of the no-fly zone operation or against people on the ground?
The USS Kearsarge and at least three Navy destroyers are now in the Mediterranean Sea. The aircraft carrier Enterprise is waiting on the other side of the Suez Canal. But to enforce a no-fly zone, Pentagon officials say they need more planes than you'd find on any one carrier.
It's an extraordinarily complex operation to set up.
And command. When General Deptula ran the no-fly mission in Iraq, he had 1,600 people and 50 jets.
We nominally spent about 6 hours of coverage on random days over random times in northern Iraq. So we weren't trying to maintain a 24-hour no-fly zone.